Hey guys, thank you for watching the Slat Rock channel. If you're new here, don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon. And if you've already done so, just check to confirm. In the famous Pipe Bomb promo, CM Punk gave a few reasons why Vince McMahon is not a billionaire. Well, he's now a billionaire, but he had some roadblocks. Today we present you 7 occasions where WWE wrestlers and others got the better of Vince McMahon and WWE in courts. Number 7. Chuck Austin brought Vince to his knees. How much training does one really need to lose a squash match? Outside of learning how to fall and taking a few drop kicks, it can't be that complicated, or can it? WWE has been telling fans for decades now not to try this at home, so they should probably realize then better than anybody that stepping inside a wrestling ring takes a considerable amount of understanding and preparation about what's going to happen when they do so. Chuck Austin didn't quite have that awareness, convincing WWE to hire him as enhancement talent despite having only less than 6 weeks' experience in the sport. In Austin's lone WWE match, teaming with Lanny Poffo against the Rockers, he improperly took Marty Jannetty's finishing move, the Rocker Dropper, instantly breaking his neck and becoming paralyzed. Austin sued the WWE for failing to prepare him for the stunt, initially earning $26.7 million when a jury agreed with him. When WWE appealed and had the amount reduced to $10 million, it still significantly beat the $3 million Austin was seeking in the suit, making the one-time jobber the clear winner, albeit at the tragic cost of never walking again. Number 6. Judge asks Vinnie Mac to get the F out. Vince McMahon's biggest defeat was losing the letters WWF to a group they still derisively referred to as tree huggers. The World Wildlife Fund was founded in 1961, beating the McMahon family to the punch at the initials no matter how you look at it. The two WWFs were able to work together in peace for decades until 1994, when the Switzerland-based environmental charity organization decided they wanted sole rights to the initials. 7 years of legal wrangling followed, ending once and for all when a judge gave full rights of the letters to the charity. In a matter of months, the World Wrestling Federation rebranded all of their logos and trademarks with a new WWE logo, and no one in the company has ever looked back. Number 5. Judgment for Owen Hart. WWE will hopefully never hold another event quite as disheartening as Over the Edge 1999, where a stunt gone wrong caused Owen Hart to fall from the ceiling to his death in the ring. The entire wrestling community mourned the incident, yet no one suffered more than Owen's widow, Martha. Feeling WWE failed to properly prepare Owen for the stunt, and knowing that her deceased husband didn't want to perform the stunt in the first place, Martha and Owen's other remaining family members sued for wrongful death. The legal proceedings were vicious and lasted more than a year, ending with WWE settling out of court to the tune of $18 million. The Harts had initially planned on suing the company that manufactured the broken harness causing Owen's fall, but changed their minds when WWE settled. Martha's relationship with WWE has understandably remained rather dicey, as it seems that the money was nowhere near enough for her to forgive them for causing her husband's early demise. Whether or not she could continue to make a legal case out of that pain is a different story. Number 4. A curious case of missing checks. Thanks to the WWE Universe rapidly expanding under his control, Vince McMahon Jr. has been sued a hell of a lot more than his father was, although that doesn't mean Vince Sr. didn't come up in some of those legal proceedings. Probably the highest profile case of Sr.'s time in charge was naturally related to the biggest star of his era, Bruno Sammartino. Shortly after Sammartino left WWE in 1981, he learned from one of McMahon's business partners, Angelo Savoldi, that the company had been shortchanging him on portions of the gate he had been promised during his second reign as WWE champion. He didn't actually file suit until 1983, when Vince Jr. had taken over for his father, and the initial suit was dismissed either way. However, things between Sammartino and the McMahons weren't all cut and dry, as Bruno was convinced he was owed money and wasn't going to let one legal victory dissuade him. Fearing further trial dates, Vince settled with Bruno out of court by rehiring him as an announcer, paying him hundreds of thousands of dollars for only a few days' work, in part to make up for their past. Number 3. I ain't got time to bleed, but I got time to count money. They say wrestling is one of the most political sports around, and few former superstars stand as living proof of this statement quite like Jesse the Body Ventura. Once one of the most flamboyant wrestlers around, blood clots forced Ventura out of the ring and made him a legendary commentator for the better part of the 80s, followed by a career in literal politics starting in the late 1990s. Ventura's interest in legal matters began well before he started signing laws as Minnesota's governor, back when he sued the WWE in 1990 over the use of his voice on video releases. Noticing some specifically worded phrases in his contract, Ventura realized he should be profiting every time WWE released something new featuring old footage of his work. Courts agreed, awarding him in the neighborhood of $900,000 and ensuring that McMahon would need to pay any time he appeared on video again. For many years, WWE circumvented this issue by bleeping Ventura's commentary on historic releases, though they were eventually able to put it behind them and work together again. Number 2. There is only one king, Vince. Jerry Lawler had never worked for Vince McMahon when he sued WWE in the mid-80s and nevertheless went on to enjoy more than 20 years with the company, beginning some 10 years after his trial ended. The issue at hand was Lawler's famous moniker as The King, which WWE has infamously used a number of times over the years as well. In this case, Harley Race was being promoted as The King, and in Lawler's home state of Tennessee no less, so Jerry took WWE to court over the use of his nickname. The courts found Lawler had been using it much longer, especially in Tennessee, and WWE needed to cease their use as a result. That the King of the Ring tournament didn't truly return to prominence until Lawler worked for the company is probably not a coincidence. Number 1. Sorry Vince, some rules won't work for me. Ever since the Monday Night Wars, the majority of WWE superstars have been forced to sign non-compete clauses as part of their contracts. This sort of agreement is exactly what it sounds like, a small legal assurance that the talent won't work elsewhere for a certain period of time after their contract with WWE comes to an end. Unless, of course, that contract ends by unusual means, or the wrestler simply decides it's ridiculous and doesn't want to do it. It seems like those two scenarios would describe almost every time a wrestler leaves WWE, and yet only two superstars thus far have really challenged the idea. This is particularly surprising considering both won, specifically Brock Lesnar in 2007 and Alberto Del Rio far more recently in 2014. In Lesnar's case, WWE wanted him to wait over 6 years before ever wrestling again, which he felt directly infringed upon his ability to make a living. Del Rio's case was pretty similar, with a shorter time frame attached, but with the bonus that he had been fired over a highly publicized racist incident where he was the victim, getting courts on his side from the start. Both wrestlers were allowed to start competing again well before their non-compete clauses would have allowed, trivializing the concept whenever WWE tries to use it again. Well guys, that's our list. Can you think of anybody else that's beaten the WWE in court? Please check out our previous video, 9 Infamous Moments Where WWE Wrestlers and Employees' Real-Life Character Was Defamed on Live TV. If you like this video, don't forget to hit that like button. Hit that subscribe button for more videos just like this one. Hit the bell icon to get notified every time we post a new video. And you can follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and Google+. And as always, thanks for watching.